Welcome back, everybody. This is Jasmuheen for the Embassy of Peace, and we are continuing on with video 7 of our series on what happens when we die. I'm an energy field scientist. In other words, I love the marriage of left brain logic and right brain intuition that leads to deep experiences of confirmation of perhaps something you were sensing could be true. Sometimes we lock into experiences like I have often in my life where I had no idea that something was possible, at least not for me. Maybe for others who were, you know, very, very special people, but not for a simple person like myself. But you know, I was born, as I've mentioned, into a family with a father who just said, often, honor your own intelligence, please, daughter, do your own research. You're an intelligent person. Research whatever you're interested in and use your discernment. Because my family came out of a period after World War II in Europe where there was so much misinformation before and also after, and an understanding that many people lived in many different realities. I know when I'm with friends and we recall shared experiences, and some of the things they remember are so different to me. And I go, you know, I don't remember that at all. And then I might share an experience and they'll say the same, or they'll go, I have a vague remembrance of that. Why is it some things stay with us? Why is it that we interpret things so differently? We hear things so differently. I notice this a lot with people I'm dealing with right now who have very, very complicated and deep mental health issues. Some of it brought on by the global changes, and some of it just because their brain, like all our brains, is plastic. We know the science of neuroplasticity, and we know that we can rewire our neural pathways by our repetitive thinking and even feeling patterns that keep us locked into or bound to very interesting realities. And in the West, our educational system regarding the reality regarding dying, life between lives, reincarnation, or any of that is quite set in certain factions. So that's why it's so important that we honor our intelligence, but we also go into the field of experiential research. And so we've been sharing through this series, how the quantum field or what you're going to experience as you drop form to go back to formlessness is going to be very unique for you, because in life and in the formlessness of no physical life, but we are still consciousness, quantum and universal rules and the unified field itself is still going to be interacting with our dominant energy signatures. That's why I like the higher light science. We hear in this world, and I hear a lot of people say, karma's a bitch. In other words, you can't escape the law of cause and effect. And this is just based on the higher light science that says we are vibrating systems of energy. And our dominant signature is determining, as it goes out from the source, us, it will determine the reality we live in, because it will bring back, as energy expands and contracts, it will bring back to its source that same energy, vibratory signature. So if we have certain beliefs that are very, very strong through our life period, and then it comes a time to drop that physical form, then this beautiful, beautiful benevolence, and this is something I have experienced a lot of, the benevolence in the unified field, it will reflect back out of the greatest love whatever we believe should happen. It does it in life, and it does it when we no longer are inhabiting specific forms. So I've seen many movies, many of you have seen different movies, I'm sure, from people who study metaphysics, or and people who have had deep experiences in near-death experiences, and or they've been under hypnosis and they've experienced profound life between life. Undeniable. Things that feel so real to them, that have permanently altered their reality and how they seem existence. So just understand that things don't just suddenly change because we've crossed over. And we want to talk about, just to wrap this, you know, in the next few moments, we want to just talk about dominant frequency spectrums, because I'm very interested in holographic realities. When I unexpectedly went into source feeding nearly 30 years ago, and then I was pushed onto the global stage, and we share a lot about this in my Inspiring Real Life Stories playlist, I realized that I was stepping into a very powerful, almost closed Western education hologram, where the biofeedback, the quantum biofeedback from that hologram was, no way, not possible, you're lying, you're, all sorts of things came back out of that. Because that reality that a simple Western woman who wasn't a saint or a yogi or a fabulous well-known guru or anything like that was claiming, that her system had gone into this experience. And in those days, for me, it was all about just love, love, love. How did it happen? Don't know, but I know it's all about the frequency of love. And obviously, I'd frequency matched through my life's experience. I'd hit a certain frequency where I could go into that and sustain that for decades. You know I have that freedom now from experience. But I had to deal educationally with a strong biofeedback from the quantum nature of that hologram. In other words, the majority of people went, no. But there were many people in those holograms as I traveled who just were going on those higher senses and just said, this feels right, actually. This feels like a field of possibility, of potential for me. So we wanted to share about that in this, what happens when we die, sharing. Because I know that there will be a point whenever you cross over where your dominant frequency of expectation is going to merge with you, because that is the benevolence there. And I also know that when we are really, really, really in our hearts, in our being, ready for a different reality that allows us to experience the magnificence of the human design and move beyond this Western education game of a massive iceberg, you only see a tiny bit on the tip of the water. Western education generally focuses on that tiny little tip. Holistic education, multidimensional, experiential education allows you to relax, relax, relax out of that limited hologram and drop back to explore the vastness of the iceberg you that dwells under the known reality above the water. And this is why metaphysicians and yogis and meditators keep espousing the virtues of sit down, shut up, disengage from especially Western and sometimes even Eastern holographic educational paradigms and just relax back to experience the totality of who we really are. And in that experience, we free ourselves from all fear of the unknown, and we free ourselves from all fear of, ooh, what happens when we die? Because in that deep experience of feeling the infinite nature of the formlessness of that which we are, we can see that really our form is just the tip of the iceberg, and we'll drop out of that when the time's right, be in formlessness, and maybe choose again to come back and play the game of being the tip of the iceberg again in a different form. Because I know, as all scientists do, about the indestructibility of energy. It cannot be created, it cannot be destroyed, but yes, it's very capable of changing form. And we, in our beautiful human construct, have an energetic matrix, an etheric matrix, that allows us to experience the true nature of the formlessness we are, and that there is no such thing as death. To have a body or to not have a body, we are still consciousness and pulsating systems of energy that the beautiful unified field responds to constantly with the greatest love to deliver what we want to bring into being, or what our dominant belief and feeling pulsations are. We hope you've enjoyed this series. Only 7, but again, if you are interested in us answering any other questions that may arise or anything else on this subject or any other, then yes, I am still in country lockdown and yes, I have time to just tune in and lodge from time to time these YouTube videos. But like you and like many, I spend a lot of time disengaging from the dominant human hologram of the fear and the uncertainty and the confusion, to rest in that vibration deep within myself of higher awareness and endless joy and endless peace. This is Jasmuheen for the Embassy of Peace.